around the world, and Lux is really strong in solo queue as well. So despite the fact that it is technically the last pick here for
in the early few waves, they've got a CS advantage, they've got a health advantage, right? It's Doran's shield and the potions already used by FBI. This is the kind of lane TSM and Doublelift want, and it's happening so far.
Exactly. You know, it's all about that push here. And Spica getting on top of him. Phase Rush is propped. Monty's in trouble here. Oh,
his flash missed. He got the slow. He's getting away. But two more autos just takes one. The Buckshot hits him in the face, and Spica puts him in the ground.
That was such poor timing. They're going to try to collapse here. Spica does have his flash.
Burn flash. He flashes, then jumps over. But he'll get a shield and a slow.
Oh,
and Spica doesn't have his jump back. Hey, this is going to be double buffs. Thank you very much. Demonte needs one more spell. Buff transfer complete. Thanks for the cash money. Thank you very much. 300 more gold on the board.
With how long it took him, I wonder if Bjergsen couldn't have moved.
Because
remember, Biofrost has no cleanse. So if you actually get a stun on him into a binding, he's just going to die.
Binding. Here comes the Q. Here comes a bunch of CC. And there is literally nothing you can do about this one. Goodbye to Biofrost. Light binding means death. And the gold gets tied.
That's rough.
The AD carries doubled with a longsword in there as well. So the Essence Reaver build, I like it about the same as Rune King, honestly. It makes you a bit more of a spellcaster. It also means if your opponents have a lot of healing and shield.
Because of the gank, because of the last couple good bindings from Huhi, it is now the Golden Guardians bottom lane who seem to have regained the push, and they're the ones really on the offensive here.
Monte not going to find the stun just yet, but that means that the Volibear certainly will, and Bjergsen's days are numbered. 18 seconds, 30 actually now till he respawns.
I mean, this is Golden Guardians again on the dragon, and I feel like, you know, TSM needs to be the ones that are actually stacking dragons to really have much chance in this game, because they're the ones that are really low on engage. They're the ones that are hurting for the win conditions as far as that is concerned. So the fact that Golden Guardians actually are the ones to get here to kill his tower, and that's kind of the decision that he did take. We'll see who gets this smite.
Fight over this one. Herald is going to be stunnable and smiteable, and it's going to go to Spica. Nicely done there. He's going to grab that one, no problem. Brooklyn in the back line. Big shields and FBI going to keep him safe. Knocking it out of Hemo Plague, and how about a re-engage? Is there one? Bjergsen on the side. Ult is going to come across, damage more towards Broken Blade, but he has a ton of healing and a ton of damage. Haunter is running out of health. And Devils is on the scoreboard with one. Now the re-engage comes through and they knock it on the top laner, but it's a 4v4. Big Q gonna come across, a stun, looking towards double, it's not gonna catch him yet, but the root, it is a stun, but it's not enough! As Bjergsen cleans up a second kill and a third as well. TSM take that team fight and Golden Guardians forced to run.
TSM getting a huge fight there. This dragon, it feels incredibly important for them to be able to do, and Demonte gonna take a little bit of poke on that side. It may come down to the smite fight here. Golden Guardians does not look like they're posturing to actually fully commit to the fight, but they do look like they're going to try to go over and combo it.
Ooh, that was a nice one. It's picked up by the damage of FBI. The laser, the Q snipe, and close.
That's like a 90% win rate, just to give some context, right? And Golden Guardians actually did lose two soul games themselves very early on, but that was with very weak late-game comps. TP coming in. We'll see if they can find an angle here.
Nice slow. Volibear over the wall. Goodbye to Biofrost. Not really good way out of that one. You are Karma. You are easily attacked in the late game. You're picked for lane bullying.
You've got to be careful. They know that the wraparound is there, so now they will move forward.
And
here's
here comes the flat flank. Here comes the big play. Shen ult over the top as well. A lot of burst damage. FBI's trying to run away. Again, the shields are coming in. He's trying to stay alive. Just bear the shields for Huhi, and they can't quite kill him. FBI on a sliver of a sliver of a fraction of a point of health. Walks away, and now this is a temporary 5v3 as Biofrost rejoins seconds. Same time as the Drake, and he can run back across the map. Close is trying to heal up on the jungle camps. TSM are healthy, and despite losing their top laner, TSM have wrested control of the jungle and are poised to take the Drake.
That was actually really smart, but Closer doesn't flash. He has no ultimate. Bjergsen and Biofrost are zoning. There comes the Lux ulti, so this should be a TSM dragon. Just a casual poking ultimate there from the Caitlyn.
Yep.
That's the power of all this AD in the build. Doublelift and Bjergsen are cut off, though.
This is a lot of damage. He's going to flash away, try to stay alive. Volley over the top. Goodbye to Ash. That's a shutdown, and Bjergsen just has absolutely nowhere to go. He's going to walk past the turret. Guarantee the kill for good measure. One more turret shot will kill him. He's always dead. A time to run for an objective.
This is so bad for TSM. Just poor positioning for them. They got split up, and Bjergsen and Doublelift both go down. Even more might die here. Broken Blade trying to look for a potential
flank. Okay, 6k health. We've got a little bit of time still. He's not hitting. Demonte's not hitting. It's really only one carry dealing damage, but they're zoned out. And look how far back Spica is going. No one's going to try to steal. And look at the Drake.
Poor communication between TSM as a squad. If anything, they could have just walked straight up the lane together as a four-man team. And that pick never would have happened. Instead, Golden Guardians gets them both. They get the Baron, and they are hunting for the soul.
This is the moment. If Golden Guardians get this Drake, it's almost unlosable. They're diving in for Devlin. They can't quite kill him, but he's at 200 HP. That teamfight's going to be hard. Doesn't have a lot of lifesteal overall, and this build didn't go Ruin King. He's going to try, knock down some of that bottom wave, get a bit of that there. Broken Blade still playing on the flank. He can be the difference maker.
16, nice, he has flash. They got to go.
Damage onto Demonte. Here comes the play, and it's going to be claimed. Infernal Soul has been grabbed, and here comes the stun on the front line. Look at the kill up the eye. Flash from the wall. Hedgepicker pops. Broken Blade's in there. A flash shield. Who he tries to keep alive, and he freaking does it. What a team fight there. Golden Guardians get two kills, and they get out. FBI.
They have taken full control of this game. They're going to get mid lane inhibitor for sure, and Double Mage just died.
There is no way to live through this one. Golden Guardians poised to close out the first game of this series.
TSM
made them work for it, but Golden Guardians, four playoff wins in a row over TSM. This best of five puts them one away from Worlds as they're going to close down game one. Still two more Nexuses to kill, but Golden Guardians pick up where they left off, destroying TSM on Summoner's Rift.
What an explosive finish here from Golden Guardians. It felt like TSM was, and Caitlyn.
Isn't ulti CDR going to feel real great picked up before Devonte has to press R the first time?
And lose their tower, or they do respond to it and they lose the dragon, but TSM's just going to rush us down. It will be a steal.
Rock wave, and it's not going to be the smite in time. Well done to Bjergsen. He might have been in range. Well, now as they've split the drakes pretty equally. Ulti used by Han Surge because he's got teammates coming around as well. Broken Blade can't sidestep much. Here comes the rest of the damage. His closer's waiting around in the wings. There's the slow. There is action.
It's going to be critical if they're playing around dragons for him to be able to QSS out of the Mord ultimate to be able to smite those dragons. So interested to see, you know, does he go for it after two items? 1v1 here from Haunter and Bjergsen.
And Bjergsen dodges every single skill shot so far. Haunter's landed the ulti and nothing else. That one's point and click. Zero way to live. Beautiful out of Bjergsen, and now the re-engage could be just as good. No way out for Demonte. Even gets the casual extra stun onto Hoovy. TSM taking control on the bottom side and just ties up the gold plus four as his turret will fall.
Bjergsen with the outplay there, utilizing the phase rush perfectly to just dodge everything Haunter could do, taking down his former teammate. They get the tower.
Ocean Drake, the rest of the squad stopping the attempt at Rift Herald, and TSM looking good in game two.
They really are. And off of that previous play, because...
He went in as Mika came around, but then Closer showed up as well. Brooklyn getting some decent damage. Here's a bit of a trade of fights. And Haunter, low enough on health, doesn't really want to ult if he doesn't have to. But there's going to go for the flash of the kickback. Brooklyn flashed the way here as well. So Closer, if he ever wants to R flash, could do so. Doesn't go for the play. Just the ward hop is enough. But now, a re-engage towards Biofries. This time, they're going to land everything they could want. A single auto finally knocks him down. If you land the ult, you land the Caitlyn trap, and you are dead from there.
Really nicely done. It is something that makes sense to talk about. As Haunter, you know, he doesn't want to ult now because he knows he's going to get chased down and killed after it, but he has to use that ult potentially defensively, but QSS is there, so he is just going to be probably gone.
Definitely in a 1v3. Thresher's up here as well. Of course, he instant QSS to knock that one down, so it's just a trade of cooldowns, and at the end of the day, it is mid lane pressure. Golden Guardians know they are roughly 3v2 in the set of the map. Arrow's going to land. Here comes the cleanse away, trying to get the damage. Dodges the Q. Speaker's in to block the rest of that one. How about the rest of the knockup? So ult comes across. They finally get the snipe. FPS going to run out of health, though. Speaker needs one more auto attack. He can't reload in time. It's not an automatic shotgun. It's got two barrels, but now Bjergsen right behind him. Look for this one as well. That's going to be an easy cleanup. Two kills picked up, but two traded back.
Very aggressive play there, FBI trying. The fact that Golden Guardians hasn't had the confidence to teamfight at any of the last couple dragons does not bode very well.
He's joined the roster. He's got more stuff. So now Haunter is in another 1v2. Flashes away from the knock of a Bjergsen. Runs at 9,000 miles an hour. Knocks off the Banshee's Veil. And now slowly walks at him and can't do nearly enough damage. Just for good measure pops the Seraph's shield. These fights are absolutely not close. So Golden Guardians are going for broke. They're trying to rush down this Baron as fast as possible. Spica is nearby. Bardal hits. They can run this one down. They can burst it down. They can grab the pickup. They grab the spike. But how about the rest of this fight? How about the rest of the crowd control? Is there a battle to be had in the 5v4? QSS popped to get away from the gold card stun. One kill for a Baron is nice, but guess what? Ocean Drake is alive.
Exactly, and Bjergsen is doing
it. My FBI's gonna grab the red buff. He's gotta get the McHale's. The Claim's gotta flash away, stays alive. Ulti gonna catch Biofrost, and TPs are coming in from all sides. Closer goes for the kick, catches Biofrost, 1-0. 5v4 the team fight. How good is it gonna look? A double knockout for Broken Blade, and Closer forced away as well. Hoovy low on health. Haunter pulled into the Death Realm with the Broken Blade here as well. A snipe on Doublet's been half HP. FBI maybe can be the carry. More damage on Broken Blade, but the cleanse, the McHale's, all those are on cooldown. No longer has tools to get away from Heart CC. but somehow Golden Guardians found a way to lost the Banshee's Veil. Ulti's gonna land. Again, they've gotta find the play. They've gotta find the CC. They gotta find the stun. The kick gets him over the wall. They're gonna chase it down though, and that's gonna be the shutdown. The damage was there, and it's time to chase on down. Without Bjergsen, this fight is a lot easier. Doublelift burns the QSS, flashes away from Hanser. Knockup engages there. He's gonna pull the ulti into Broken Blade. They're gonna fight 1v1 as Speak is forced to run backwards. Easy scuttle take here for TSM, but it's gonna be Golden Guardians who want to chase Speak at 200 health. Flashes over the wall, and there is no contest here for the Elder Dragon. Speaker trying to regen up. He gets a lot. Ocean Drake plus hitting jungle monsters, but it is a 5v4. Bjergsen cannot be in this fight, and they cannot steal the Elder Dragon. So Golden's in. Bot lane taking some damage. Couple of cannon minions there as well. A little bit more poke comes in. First turret finally falls. Baron on for 1 minute here as the Elder falls off. Golden Guardians go for the ulti. They get two. They get two. Here comes the engage. And they're going to pull back. Doublelift and flashless. He will die. A stopwatch. Azonius keeps Devontae alive. The second turret is now gone as well. And they've pulled in the fight. They've looked for the kill. Broken Blade burns the QSS. The Nexus is falling. And Golden Guardians 2-0 in the best of five.
Oh my god. Huhi again. Finding the incredible ultimate here. Golden Guardians battling back against Ocean Soul. Pick after pick. That was incredible from them. Yeah. Your itemization becomes incredibly simple this game. Pretty darn standard these days. But where he goes after that is going to be the main question. You know, Triforce is the most standard. But will he go towards a Wit's End or something?
And also there is some danger because the jungler was known to be topside with the Herald take. Decent damage towards Doublelift here. Second plate is claimed. And that is an ulti onto him. That is a lot of damage available. The flash engage. They're going for double, forcing the flash away to keep him alive. But Bowercross right over the wall, finding a stun here towards Closer. He can ultimate when he needs to and does so, but the rest of the squad is still on the chase. Looking for another stun. A dunk backwards. They're going to grab first blood. Speak of doing it all.
Great punish there from TSM.
And maybe a second soon for TSM as Doublelift tries to bait in, and there's the play towards FBI. Not going to be stunned, but Biofrost is certainly going to be rooted. Herald summons, but it might not get too much done. Actually, let's answer this one as FBI has to cleanse away, and this wave is definitely getting shoved in. Bit of damage for Doublelift, but this turret's going to need a lot of health right now. TP play comes in, root towards Bjergsen. Decent damage dealt, forced to flash away, as there's one kill for Demonte, gets a shield and wants to keep going. Is there more to be had? Obviously, the gold goes through to Spica as the Herald crashes. The plate not
raided by the Golden Guardians bottom lane, despite having the numbers advantage. And because of that huge HP advantage, they're now going to try to go for FBI. No
big
plan.
Shuffle. FBI flash to stay alive. That's going to be a nice ulti for Biofrost. Is there a re-engage? Spica wants in, dunks him right back. That's going to be almost a kill, but first he kills up Biofrost, and here comes the rest of the squad as Closer also kills Spica. So it's a 3-1 overall play for Golden Guardians, plus the Drake, plus Demonte wants more. Big Benson gave him trouble, but Tanner Time's going to push Bjergsen away.
Yep.
Jump, protobelt, Q, really good wave clear there, and Bjergsen will at least answer the bottom turret. That's first turret of the game. But hey, Blade of the Ruin King means sustain, means Broken Blade's going to go back to full in a wave or two.
And that's where you can see that this lane starts to go bad here, but they find the pick on FBI potentially. No damage.
Damage, but he's got the healing. They're going to go for the re-engage. Bartleby buys some time, but the re-engage, the stun, it's not going to be there just yet as Biofrost flashes to the Magical Journey. Speaking of some plays as well, gets some punches across to Monte. Going to back out as well. Knew he was going to be safe to do that play. Ulti's traded back and forth, but now health bar's getting a bit low. Bjergsen wants back in. He has the ulti. Not going to go. Now he is. Scoops in three. Look at that play. They're going to get a whole lot done. Two kills picked up. Make it a third. Huge out of the TSM mid laner.
Bjerger kick going on.
See what can happen next. The Drake spawning in 45 seconds. Golden Guardians did get the most recent one, as we are going to be in a Cloud Soul map, as Biofrost will be rooted in place, take a little bit of poke, and now Huhi is going to be a target. This is going to be such an easy kill. Stun's not going to land, but the slow's certainly there. No way out for you. Goodbye. Support is gone just in time for the Drake to spawn in 25 seconds.
And that was really well-timed by Biofrost. He knows that shield is on cooldown. You have no flash. There's no way you can actually avoid that close-range Bard ultimate. So they kill off the support. The Rift Herald charges. They could get two towers right off this push, and TSM opening up a gold lead here. Showing signs of life, and it's been so interesting in this series because Golden Guardians are so well known for their incredible early game and then their mid game playmaking available for them in this game than there was in the previous ones. You know, Huhi notably had been monstrously strong.
Types of utility style items. Third, Bjergsen though, with the heavy attack speed, three soldiers out, they're gonna knock down the tower, and now Demonte in trouble.
Good damage. Demonte gonna have to ult pretty soon, does so, but he's in the middle of literally the entirety of TSM, and Devilus grabs his kill as Vengeance. From the first time he TP'd back down to the bottom, I would say that I don't hate Cleaver because there's an armor stack here, but Bjergsen's going to lose the Banshee's Veil, just gets out of the stun, goes to the backwards shuffle, and Demonte can have a hard time catching back up, but he can try. I mean, Bjergsen's ultiless, jumps back to the soldiers, puts a turret down here as well, goes for as much damage as he can, and Demonte taking too much damage, just has to jump out, doesn't have any MR, doesn't have quite the burst of
Closer,
AP.
Though.
Sentinel finds some damage, Closer wants in, smites, claps, and it took four of them! But they finally find themselves that kill. They couldn't get the shield on
Baron.
Who's been champion. But yes, with three showing bot lane, Baron is the target. This was what led the Golden Guardians come back in game two. It could seal the deal for TSM in game three. Team is coming around. Haunter could always ult the jungler. 5k has flash, he does burn it. He's trying to get away, but can't get too far. Ulti over the top from a couple of people, and they're gonna knock in the mid laner. That is most of the gold gone. So Haunter pulls in the ulti. He's gonna catch Doublet. Double's gonna have a really hard time kiting a Mordekaiser without anywhere to go. He's stuck in the ring. He's stuck in the circle. The Monte gets him as he comes out of the death realm. And Golden Guardians have found their way into a team fight yet again. They one-shot the captain. This time around, you are not FBI, Biofrost.
You can just auto-attack Ashe to dead at that point. So Golden Guardians looking for this Baron here, and it looks like they're gonna get it.
And Demonte is going to be the one to zone out the jungler, keep Broken Blade away. He's going to run out of health, but not before the Baron dies.
Hoohe
gets chopped down as well, though. TSM, how much can they get? Doublelift has the global ulti available. It's going to be a defensive recall from one. Haunter is alone against four. How many does Golden Guardians lose? They've lost three. They're going to lose a fourth, as well as the arrow from downtown finds Closer. And you may have gotten Baron, but the gold lead's going to go to TSM. Give the kill over, a shutdown to Broken Blade. Buffing up the minions nearby. It's as strong as five buffing up the minions, so it does make the siege pretty decent. And so how much can Golden Guardians get?
There's no one answering Broken Blade, so they're actually just trying to trade for this. Bjergsen has Death Gap. They're looking for the dive.
Looking for the hard dive, 5v4, dunk backwards in from the set. Turret turned off by Bullabear, but it doesn't matter. TP comes in, here comes Jax. Pulled in the death realm by Haunter, keeps his backliner alive, but he will lose his life for this play. Cannot fight Broken Blade. He's going to be killed off, and who he is next to fall. TSM have turned it on in game three.
And look at the pings towards the bot lane minion wave that's already pushed up there. TSM is trying to get
Flash didn't realize that the man didn't have it. As the third Drake goes over to TSM, one away from Cloud Soul now. Move speed definitely pretty important when you've got a fairly FBI is going to find a route. They're going to find a lot of damage in a Biofrost, but he's going to cleanse, he's going to flash away, and now Doublelift the target, flashes himself, but Bonte is on the chase!
Oh no!
And that Tempered Fate will not save his life. That is always your kill. However, turrets are falling, Inhibitor is gone in two different lanes. Nexus turrets falling as well. Golden Guardians must defend 5v4 and make it a 4v4 as instantly Haunter dies. They're going for more. TSM trying to find this win, and they will most certainly do it. As health bars get low, it's kills across the board, and TSM win game three.
TSM staying alive in this series.
Those champions from it. Now that can be very, very powerful.
Okay.
Galio coming through, so that's really more for the pairing with the Leona.
With bot pressure, with these amount of mid pressure, first Rick's going to go over pretty early on as well. 7:36 is a pretty early timer regardless, so TS is fine. And now we get to see Golden Guardians. It's 9 minutes in. Of course they are. They're topside. They're going to play for Rift Hero. They've done this almost every single game in this series. They're trying to stack this one up the best they can. You've got TSM coming around there for the same, and the entire squad's ready to go for this one. This is going to be a fight really, really soon, and the health bar's getting low on Golden Guardians. Stun the front line. Hoohe is tanky, gets the ulti across for the shield, but he's still running out of health. Finds a slow into Bjergsen, finds a Galio, but not before First Blood comes through. Smitable grabs the Rift Herald. They're going to grab that one, but first the fight, and Demonte is death number two. So Golden Guardians, at best, are going to get 300 gold for the Rift Herald, but they've lost 900 gold worth of kills.
And they might actually lose more here. Easy spear there for Spica against the wall.
That's another kill picked up, so Golden Guardians falling apart later on in the series as TSM.
That is something that is really, really impressive to see, and it does speak to the knowledge of TSM on how to extend.
Orianna's here first. This could be a
shockwave.
The first knockup. Hoohe's in the front line. He's tanky enough. It's a flash away from Closer, but he didn't need to. No one's in range of him. Hoohe in the front. Galio over the top. They find a lot of damage on Renekton, but he is not yet going
away.
Death realm, but it's already too late. One, two, three kills picked up, and Broken Blade's got no problems at all. It's four already. Broken Blade buying some time. Gets the heal. Gets the reinforcements. Gets the shield, and Haunter is going to drop. This is going to be the Bud Light Ace. Golden Guardians have been crushed so far in game.
He doesn't commit the shockwave early. He knows they don't actually need to. As Hoohe goes down, the rest of Golden Guardians try to move forward to get in range.
The red side pick going Senna into Ashe hasn't done enough to carry, as you've been mentioning before. Bot lane turret's going to fall likely first here. To the credit of TSM, they are getting this gold dip to 6,000. Yeah, that'll be answered partially because eventually top lane might die. I mean, very slowly by Galio auto attacks, but this is getting out of hand so quick. TSM are crushing right now in this game.
They are. It's looking pretty dangerous, and We'll see what Golden Guardians can do. They have a lot of playmaking, so that is something worth.
Kills front now, either, but Doublelift cheating up in the mid lane, knocking down the turret. Bjergsen doing the same in the top side. TSM about to be 3-1 in turret score, or nearly that, as mid lane is going to be held alive. But no one's going to answer top side, so TSM just grow their gold lead.
And Doublelift over a level ahead. You know, he was 10 when.
Naka speaking to be pretty safe on this one. Protobelt in for more damage, but there's just no way out. Just out in time. Ash Arrow a quarter second too late. Doublelift cannot force the kill on Demonte, but still slowed, able to walk away.
And they're going to get mid lane turret for free. We'll see if they can get two towers, because Demonte's got a base. The first one is a foregone conclusion. They can actually kill it before the charge, and then we're going to have the full HP Herald charge for it.
Shouldn't be allowed to live. Sidesteps the ulti, really good reflexes there, but he's still alone, going to be under the turret, pops his own ult. It's going to be Huhi frontlining. He's very, very tanky with F-Shock on. Gets stunned, should survive the turret shots. I don't think he needed his stopwatch, but he will walk away no problem. And the one kill and a Drake, that's an okay trade.
Yeah, they're losing their whole topside jungle as well, but, you know, from a losing spot.
All of the Fog of War to look at Baron ever. I feel like TSM might have an easy time doing a Baron setup. TP coming down to the bottom side as Hanser wants to start the 1v1 against Broken Blade with the reinforcements coming soon. Not a lot of good ways out. A flash to get away from the pull, but he's still on top of the enemy squad, and that is a one kill for nothing. TSM might try to re-engage. That's going to be difficult.
Global
setup ult available.
And Bjergsen is cut off. They're just going to turn on Bjergsen now. He is captured here.
Galio over the top. Flash can't get him away. Shockwave buys a bit of time, and you gotta be kidding, he walks away with his life. Closer's in danger, so is Hanser. A double kill for the Spica. This is the Nidalee that people were looking for. And it's time for a bit more. TSM walking in now towards who he have felt in Leona, trying to walk away. More slows coming in to taunt, puts Biofrost sub 15 health, and it will be a kill for Demonte. The re-engage for Spica, the re-engage for Doublelift, and who he will lose his life. FBI could be next. He is gone. Golden Guardians base, open up. It's TSM knocking.
Scream. And as the rest of the team committed over to taking out Bjergsen, Doublelift and Spica just tore through the other side. TSM winning. Plus the Orianna E, plus everything else. They're looking for the pick on Bjergsen.
Shot.
They've got no flash, and Biofrost could go here. He has his ultimate really soon.
Stun on Mort. Mort ult down for a few seconds. It's just back now. He would have loved to target Biofrost and couldn't do so. And this is TSM with complete
three levels up on FBI. The Senna just isn't working here for the Golden Guardians, and TSM are closing in on this game. Three level 14 characters right here. The highest on Golden Guardians is 12. Look at these guys. They're just heavily outstated purely from the levels.
Everyone's up 1,000 gold except for the supports right here. It's everyone is ahead. Here comes a double slow, not a stun. Now on a Doublelift, looking for the engage, but they don't quite have all of it. Hanser in the back line, looks for Bjergsen and can't do a whole lot. Still trying for Doublelift. They will find that first kill, but Hanser will trade his life. A one for one against Baron is not a bad play, but it's going to be more than that one. There's the knockup. There's the kill. Biofrost loses his life. Shockwave pulls one back in. It's a 3v3. Make it a 3v2. The taunt is not going to mean a lot. Spica's going to stay alive through this one. Demonte is not. There is the ace. A triple kill for Bjergsen. The ace for Broken Blade just 4 minutes after the last one. And TSM are ready to push right in to close out game four. And it's a fast one. We're 24 minutes and 10 seconds in. And TSM are bringing us silver scrapes.
TSM will not go quietly into the night, forcing the game five, challenging Golden Guardians here, and threatening the reverse sweep to keep their world's dreams alive. 7-0-10, Nidalee performance from Spica. 7-0-10 from Bjergsen. That is some mid-jungle synergy right there.
You know, yeah, with Pantheon, or even if they went to the Thresh, I think Thresh is great. Like,
sure,
this,
sure,
is,
sure.
This is a very threatening 2v2. You could
for it. Looking for a javelin, maybe. Finally sidesteps it, but Hanser is bleeding gold and bleeding XP from Speak Empathic topside.
And I love that they didn't overcommit to it. We'll see if Golden Guardians actually do commit to this dive. It looks like they want to. They're TPing in. It's level 2.
The play we saw a game ago. Is it going to be enough for the kill? It is! And who he flashed out of turret range. But Closer is on the wrong side of this fight. He's going to be easily claimed. The Lantern!
Oh! In the series, it has actually been the opposite. You know, they have been losing the early games to TSM. And TSM, in the first two games, wasn't able to close out. It was actually Golden Guardians that had the superior playmaking and the superior, more defensive option. Less about the roaming, of course. Does get hooked up.
Mertritz of a bit value here as he flashes over. Could it be enough? Could it be enough? Two more autos. They get the kill picked up. Nicely done. Despite the Merc treads, the CC chain is too much. Ignite goes over the top. Exhaust is not enough. It's going to be top lane first turret of the game. The Herald was picked up from top lane pressure, from mid lane pressure, and a lot of money goes over. TSM feeling really comfortable around top side. Golden Guardians feeling comfortable around bottom side. They've knocked some turret plates down. They will get this Drake as well. All is well. Plates are still on. Doublelift is in a 1v3. Here comes the bear. He certainly don't care. And Doublelift's health bar is gone. There is no way you should really be there, to be honest. And that's going to be a turret in the top side. A turret in the...
FBI up on that top side. They're going to take Harold. They're going to try to take that top lane tower down and continue injecting more and more gold into FBI.
And look what TSM is getting. You know, they're going to walk forward. They're going to land the marble. This is almost certainly going to be a kill. The bombs are down. Goodbye. Big damage there on DeMonte. Has a lantern, but the bomb is on his head, and he's going to die anyway. And the mid lane turret falls all the same. You may have gotten a Harrow, but what does it do but turret damage, which TSM already got in the mid lane. They're getting it in the bottom lane as well. Didn't even have the cross map arrow. TSM at 15 minutes, playing better League of Legends.
Yeah, they're just moving around the map and getting way more. It's like, okay, so we talked about Renekton, he's your super fed player, and Kalista is your super fed player. Kalista is 1v0, right? Kalista is farming against minions.
Well, TSM fighting over wards, but will they fight for the smite? They're gonna try to walk around, Javelin's gonna come in, not gonna be contested. Drake number three in for Dragon Soul can certainly be defeated. Now looking at Broken Blade. Now it's the Fed members fighting each other. FBI going to find a slow, going to keep going for the auto attacks. But without Rend, it's not the most damage on a low health champion. But the hook is perfect, and the Bard ult only hits two. FBI was not gold, and Golden Guardians find their fifth kill.
Closer giving the thumbs down to his good friend Broken Blade as they take him down. They get the flash ult and kill off him. Very valuable there. TSM does like, so I imagine he has more gold than he has spent, but DeMonte in trouble.
Finds a stun. They go in for Bjergsen here as well. CZ going to come across. Hook's not going to land. Here comes the teleports. Here comes the play. This could be the deciding moment because Dragon Soul could close it out as who he walks in.
Haunter.
Lances in Haunter. Tries for the play. Double force to run, but they're going to find three stuns. Bjergsen ults himself. How about the re-engage? They force out the Zillion ult. They're going to let him revive. Closer very low. Force to flash away. Can they find the re-engage? Asher are going to land. Stopwatch buys time. Hook is going to catch Bard. Ulti coming across. They will knock down Bjergsen. 4v5 on the map. FBI low needs to find some raptors or some wolves to lifesteal off of, and he will do that. Again, 5v4 on the map. Soul for Golden Guardians, and Spica lands the javelin. They land. Oh, that is a troll ult. He's going to kill himself before the spike. Biofrost, who are you working for? No chance at a spite steal, and Spica dies for nothing. Both, and it was catastrophic.
Yeah, that was rough, because, I mean, he actually hit the Q, right?
So for them, there is a ward that shows three of TSM. They know what's happening. They're going for Bjergsen. Here comes the fight. Close are going to kite right back out. They find a hook on a Bard. Not the ideal target, but a big stun means they might force the ulti, and he's not going to revive him. That is a 1-0. That is Tempered Fate and Fate's Call. Throwing in. And they're not going to find the hook just yet, but they do still get that kill. And a stun from long range puts Closer at 200 health. Elder Soul while hitting the Elder itself, so you don't always get everything you want. There's the flash. They try to catch him. With Fate's Call, they catch him. This could be the kill, but you got to be careful of the re-engage from Haunter there as well. Is it going to be enough as the revives come through? DeMonte knocks down Bjergsen, and they're going to find a second.
Broken Blade!
So far, Broken Blade running over this game right now. Closer going to be next. He tries to journey away. It's not going to be enough. Dragon Soul be damn, TSM win the fight. They're going for the base.
Broken Blade's TPing in. They want to close this out. Broken Blade got in the middle of everyone. The Renekton running over the fight. I don't think they have the minions to do this. I think it was an overeager call. They need to go back to this Elder.
Get the turret at least.
We'll see if they're going to go for it. Yeah, but then you risk the TPs coming through. Haunter and DeMonte both have TPs, so they're going to get the tower. They are going to back it off. That seemed like they got a little bit excited there. Potentially thought they could end the game. We'll see if they can secure the Elder here for themselves.
Did their homework, they did the math, they did the calculations. They said, we have enough time for the bottom inhibitor turret and enough time for Elder Dragon and TSM. Will they contest? Closer will have to ult in for it, puts a new ward down, and of course he can Lantern out as well. 3k health, Lantern can get vision. They've got to try for this play. They absolutely must, I think, have to try for the steal, and they're trying to bait it around. They're trying to play around the vision. Bardolt comes in, it's gonna be stolen! It's tanner time! And it's not time for Golden Guardians to lose just yet.
Kind of cut off on the side, the Baron minion. So TSM has got to get back into the base and try to defend this inhibitor tower because it's gonna go down so quick. Doublelift on the side though. He doesn't have his ultimate quite yet.
FBI is getting flanked by Broken Blade.
They got to CC chain this guy. They got to do a lot. There's a stopwatcher. There's Tempered Fate building a lot of time, and they're going for Huhi. He could be an easy target. He's stunned up in place, and they can't save him. So back in goes Kennen. Looks for the stun. Looks for Biofrost. One hit would kill him, but he can't die. Broken Blade safe on the side. Broken Blade finds the kill on Demonte, and it's time to run away. The revive on Renekton. Not an easy kill. Speaker.
FBI
wants in, but he runs it down in mid and gets stunned up and killed. A lantern to buy some safety. It's not going to be enough. It's two unanswered kills for TSM.
A lot here. Bjergsen forces out the first flash. They're going to find some bit more damage. Closes in danger. Going to find a stun. Looks for a lantern. Cannot get out. And that might just be the play that closed the playoff loop. TSM ready to push in. They are pushing in forward. 15 seconds, 10 now on Demonte, 20 on FBI. Somehow a 2v5 defense must be the play, and it simply cannot happen. We bid farewell to Golden Guardians, and TSM are just 3 wins away from making it back to Worlds with a date with Cloud9.
The reverse sweep happens for TSM. They pull it back again.